Hi everybody, Big Bong here. As most of you know, I attended Langfest, a big event for language enthusiasts in Montreal. It was so nice to meet all these brilliant minds from all over the world. But anyway, today I would like to present an amazing tool, which is called CJKVDIX, and that I wish I had when I just started learning both Korean and Chinese 7 years ago. Now I had the pleasure to meet Emmanuel Ternon, who is none other than the creator of the app, so I thought, why not make him introduce his own project? Here we go.
So yeah, basically I'm a software engineer that has also a passion for East Asian languages, so Chinese, Japanese, and Korean. And when I was learning these languages, I noticed that, you know, there were a lot of words in common. It's about actually 60% of the vocabulary that is in common between these languages. And I thought it would be nice to have a dictionary that shows, you know, the common words between these languages. So, for example, if you look for a Japanese word, then it would show you the equivalent Korean word, for instance. And to do this, I was using pre-existing dictionaries such as Naver, for example, as I guess many people who learn Korean know, or Jisho.org for Japanese. Yeah. And what I was doing is basically looking for a Korean word on Naver and then copying the Chinese characters that would be used to write this word and look them up on the Japanese dictionary, for instance. Mm-hmm. Sometimes it worked, but in many instances it didn't, because I noticed that Chinese characters in Japanese were simplified. So the Japanese dictionary would expect that you enter the simplified Japanese characters, obviously, and not the traditional characters that are used in Korean. And the same problem happens for Chinese, actually. So a Chinese dictionary would expect the simplified Chinese characters and not the Japanese simplified characters, etc. Okay. So I thought, yeah, maybe I could do a dictionary that kind of combines everything and automatically converts any kind of simplified characters to traditional, so that you can see how this word is used in all these languages. And yeah, based on this idea, so I got to work and I gathered some databases online, some open source databases for dictionaries, and I ended up with a dictionary that is called CJKVDIX. So CJKV stands for Chinese, Japanese, Korean, and Vietnamese. And with this dictionary, you can basically enter a word in any of these languages, in any writing system, either phonetically or in Chinese character, and you will get the equivalent that this word has in any other languages.
That's pretty awesome. So let's try it. I think that's the best way to show the people how it works.
Yeah, we can try it. So basically, for example, if you take the dictionary, and if you look up the Japanese word, let's say, keizai.
Keizai, okay, let's do all that. Right. Keizai, do I need to go to Japanese or not?
Not necessarily. It's kind of automatic. Keizai.
All right.
So if you were to enter this word in a Chinese dictionary, you wouldn't get anything, because actually the characters were simplified in Japanese, but not the same way that they were simplified in Chinese.
Okay.
So if you press search here, then after the searching algorithm has finished, you get to see the definition of this word in Chinese, in Japanese, in Korean, and in Vietnamese. So yeah, to change the language, you can just press the Chinese character that corresponds to the language you want to have. So you have the Chinese character for China, for Japan, for Korea, and for Vietnam.
And you always have the traditional one.
Yes, you always have the traditional and the simplified form in square brackets. So either the Japanese simplified or the Chinese simplified.
All right, so how do you read that in Chinese?
It's jingji. Okay, so here in the dictionary, I put the Bopomofo, which is the transcription that they use for Mandarin in Taiwan. But if you press the entry, you will see the pinyin and the Cantonese in what's called the Yuping romanization system. Yes.
Can you read that or?
Not really.
Okay.
I don't speak Cantonese, sadly, unfortunately. Yes, jingji. And in Korean, it's kyongji, absolutely.
Really nice. Okay. Right.
And and if you press the last button on the far right, then you will get information about each individual character. So for example, this character means like classic words or pass through, and you get all of its readings in all of the languages of that use Chinese characters. So Mandarin, Cantonese, Japanese, Korean, and Vietnamese.
Cool, wonderful. Just let me check the
That's basically the Vietnamese equivalent. So sadly, I don't speak Vietnamese myself, but I got a lot of requests from people to include Cantonese and Vietnamese as well, because a lot of people who learn these languages also take advantage of this property of having the same word in each of these languages written differently, basically.
Cool, man. I think it's a brilliant project. And what are you planning to do with it?
I want to add some options to be able to have the pinyin or maybe the Cantonese instead. Yeah. For Japanese, maybe to have like the Romaji instead of the Kana, things like that.
Okay.
And yeah, who knows, maybe in the future I'll add some extra features like, you know, character stroke orders or maybe text-to-speech or things like that if I have enough time to, cool. to do this.
Do you need internet to use it or can you use it offline?
That's the cool thing with the app. So basically there's a web version that you can use on the internet, on the website. So it's cjkv-dict.com. Okay. And so that's online, obviously. But if you download the app, it's completely offline. So you can use it even when you don't have access to the internet where you are, basically.
Okay, perfect. Again, thank you so much, Emmanuel, for creating such a wonderful tool. For those of you who are interested in Chinese characters, you should also check out the book he wrote on the subject. Other than that, I also had the chance to meet Steve Kaufman, founder of the language app, Link. So stay tuned for that as well.
Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Keep following, stay awesome, and spread this channel.
Thank you, Mark. How nice of you. Yeah, I also gave a speech with Mark during Langfest. It's going to be posted on Langfest's YouTube channel, so stay tuned for that too. All right, I hope this video was useful to you, and I'll see you soon for more videos. Bye.